For some reason or another, UNET booting doesn't seem to have succeeded in correctly writing the operating system to this disk. So we're going to try again over here. I need to quickly open up some things. I can't remember the commands off the top of my head. UNET booting didn't work for some reason, but that's kind of convenient because it gives us an opportunity to show how to do this process from Linux distributions. Ubuntu, which is what we're going to install today, has the Linux kernel, and then for the window, for the graphics manager, for what you interact with, you have what's called Unity. And then for a package manager, which is how you download your software, essentially like a kind of more basic app store, you have Aptitude. So that's kind of the three main components of a Linux operating system. Nowadays anyway, you have the kernel, your window manager, and your package manager. Those are the primary components that differentiate a package, a distribution for the end user. Those are the ones that people typically choose their distribution on. There's various other bits that can be changed, and there's lots that can be tweaked in a distribution, but those are the primary concerns. You might be used to have Windows, you want a new piece of software, you want a program to open a certain file, you have to go trawling Google, find the download link, download it and install it. Whereas package managers were kind of app stores before app stores existed. You just open up your package manager, find what you want, one click installation, it downloads the perfect one for your machine. You don't have to worry about choosing the right download, don't have to worry about viruses, it's all verified, and you get your software. So we're gonna use this, do this using a command line utility called dd, which will let us extract the ISO to this disk and hopefully have some success. I don't know the commands off my head, so I'm gonna copy and paste them from this page. So it's really easy to get the commands to do this. Lots of people have done this before, and there's lots of invaluable lines. This is from the Ubuntu forum, how to burn an ISO to a USB device. The dd command requires two parameters. So we need to have the ISO which we're writing to it, and we need to have the mount point of the device. So the mount point is the directory in the file system where this device is mounted. So it's quite an arcane looking piece of information, and it's quite difficult to find unless you know the commands, but we can use gparted, which is a graphical user interface application, to really easily find that. So we can see here that it's /dev/sdb. So we'll whack that in, and we've already got the ISO in there. So now if I do that, got into my password. I think I ran the command without any output, so I'm now just going to sit here and wait and hope that's working. The dd command, unless you give it the option to do so, doesn't display any diagnostics, and I didn't give it that command. So I'm now sitting here hoping and praying that it is actually in fact doing what it should be doing. We've written to dd with the stick, and I've just checked to see if it's working, so basically I plugged it in, changed the boot option to USB. On this machine, so not on our victim. Plugged it in, changed the boot option to USB. It went through to boot fine, booted up into Ubuntu, and when it first boots, it presents you an option whether you want to try Ubuntu, so run it straight off the stick, or whether you want to install it. So now we're going to have the moment of truth and try it on the patient.